I'm a videographer, YouTuber, husband. Yes, somebody actually is attracted to me and wanted me. One-armed freak, disabled. Two terms I heard growing up that made me hate myself. I mean, I never felt disabled. That term implies that my ability to do things is somehow impaired or that I am simply just not able. I'm Daniel, by the way, and growing up, I just wanted to be the same as every other kid in my class. And I have a very visible difference, which kind of makes me stand out a little bit. I was born with one arm. This annoyingly obvious physical difference of mine meant that I had to deal with name calling, questions, obvious looks, stares. Plus, there was no one I could look up to on TV, in the magazines, that looked remotely like me. They all had two arms. I didn't know what life would be like for a one-armed guy. And that uncertainty and the self-doubt created a load of fears for me about growing up and what my future would look like. When I thought about my future, I would think, what woman would take a downgrade from a two-armed guy down to a one-armed guy? What company would hire a one-armed guy? Would I be able to have kids, hold a baby, drive a car? Growing up, I certainly didn't think I was going to be a pilot, a brain surgeon, or a male model. I actually struggled to think of a career that someone would be willing to pay me to do. I'm a videographer, YouTuber, husband. Yes, somebody actually is attracted to me and wanted me. And a dad as well, two kids. Thankfully, I didn't get bullied on a regular basis. However, there were times where people would resort to really harsh name calling, which I found really hard. I think the people that called me names were probably just dealing with their own challenges in their life. And the people that were staring, they were probably just curious because they hadn't seen a guy with one arm before. So day to day, I've got lots of things to do, one hand to do it with. Texting, I've just learned to do with one hand. My thumb is just constantly on the go. Kids, one of them goes on my back, the other one I'm holding on the front. I have to drive to the shop to pick up the shopping, which, you know what, I still manage to carry all the bags in at once. I work at a computer most of the time when I'm working, so I've got a mouse that I've programmed to do a lot of the keys, which I can just use with my fingers. So I am not disabled, I'm differently abled. People often ask, if I could have two arms, would I take that if someone was offering it to me? And I think there'd be a part of me that would say, that is tempted to say yes, but I think I'm so confident in myself and comfortable with who I am now that I know that having this one arm has made me who I am today. I think owning who I am actually is helping my children own who they are. I could have let this thing bother me. And yeah, it's maybe a little bit more obvious than the things that other people are dealing with. But it's no bigger or no more difficult. I think actually we could all do a better job at being vulnerable and real about what we're going through and the things that we find hard in life. You are loved and you are cherished and you have got so much to bring to this world and the people around you.